Operations report. Submarines detected. Repairs complete. Contact report. Oh, we hit a sub chaser. Good. What's a KD? Whatever this is. It's a submarine. Supposedly hit. Contact report. Contact report. Contact report. Contact report. Contact. Kill credit. Contact report. Hurricane. Oh, God. Oh, I guess I'm still taking pictures over Tanjung Pinang. That's fine. I'm setting it on continuous. Repairs complete. Expansion. Upgrades. Replacements taken. Reinforcement Los Angeles, Portland, Los Angeles. Wow, lots. Eastern. Charter Towers. Fighter Group. Oh, wow, okay. I better check on that. Reinforcement Marchfield. Wow. Reinforcement Pearl Harbor, Seattle, all through, and Port Hueneme. I better check. Charter Towers. Whoa! They just showed up. Bam! Oh, how nice! B-38 Gulf. Okay, well, have to see what to do with these. I guess these are meant to be sent. What's the range of these babies? 40. So we could conceivably send them. Hong Kong. Submarine in. S-34. Back out to the gauntlet. Shanghai. Whoa, one submarine thresher damaged. Put her in the shipyard. Critical. The other three, one for each patrol station, it looks like. Aircraft. Still trying to recover the last bit of fatigue out of here. Maybe I'll fly them off anyway, with a level one. Get them down to Kota Baru. Same here, level one. Make room for the new bombers coming in. Keijo! See, the base requirement is 13,000. I need twice that, I believe. Bombers flying from a base that does not have twice the base requirement. I believe the penalty is 75% of the aircraft will fly. Only 75%. And I need every damn bomber flying. So this base is not ready to fight yet. They're almost recovered. Almost recovered, but I don't want to fly the mission with only 3/4 of my fight of the bombers. To this end, on Changchun, I've requested a little bit more than necessary. But unfortunately, this might be starving supplies to Keijo. I've been keeping it up so that we can get reinforcements. You need 20,000 on a base in order to get reinforcements. So I've kept it up, but now I think I'm going to drop it down. I might be taking it away from Keijo and not letting her double up. The bombers on Changchun are also recovering nicely. B-17s from long range. Here's some more of the P-38 Gulf. We moved up from here. Okay, we've attacked them, and the enemy held! The damn base held! God darn it! So we're going to attack again this turn, but the 5th Chinese Corps is scheduled to withdraw tomorrow, unfortunately. Let's see, is the general worth saving? The general is a 51. There's lots worse, down to 34. And there's lots better up to 69, so he's kind of a middling general. Which means I don't think he's worth the political points to save. So lots more. He's Chinese. There's lots more from where he came. I think we're gonna disappear. We've already turned off the replacements so that we don't waste any replacements that are gonna disappear. We're gonna shock attack with this guy. Burn them up! Burn them up! On Harbin, yes! 12,000 have arrived. 12,000, we're going to shock the hell out of you. Oops. All right, let's make sure there are no engineers, artillery. Yeah, everybody else is going to just shock away. We finally got one in behind them to surround. Now that we're behind, let's move in. Oops. Let's get on the train so we can redeploy once we take the base. Still working our way around Tsitihar. No other reinforcements coming. Fusan, Chinhai, has been fighting hard. Taking losses. Not cheap. These people, the battles have not been cheap. And without 20,000 in supply, we can't just grab reinforcements on here. So it's a penalty. Over on Seishin, we are also taking losses here. Unable to get reinforcements. Yeah, we're putting up with it as we move, as we march down. Maybe if we take Yankee, we can try to consolidate some of these. But not yet. We're just going to have to fight at a disadvantage for in the next little while. Okay, I have room on Kota Baru. Yeah. I'm going to bring the Ventura over to Kota Baru now. Yes, I understand they aren't in perfect shape yet. They are not totally relieved, but that's just one guy. Let's see, Kota Baru. Hold on. Wait a minute. Are we saying we can't even get to Kota Baru? Ventura? Oh, 43 hexes. Okay, 43 takes them to about here. Alright. Kota Baru is 51. So good for the double bomb, double engines, but not for these guys. Sure. Let's go to Bangkok. No crash. Good. Still waiting. Let's make sure the state range of zero. Jeez. Wow. No wonder they're under fatigue. Transfer, Bangkok. No crash. Don't crash. Well, one damaged, not a crash. These guys should be able to make. Oops. What? Why is this 11? Good grief! What a screw up. I could have used drop tanks. Didn't know they had drop tanks on these things. Oh well, we'll go Kota Baru. One crash. Transfer Kota Baru. Was that another crash? I don't know. We'll move them over. Now that we freed up some space on Amoy, we can bring some more stuff into Shanghai. Fighters or bombers or whatever else. We have two more on the rail. Set all to march. These guys have arrived. Oops, no. Same here. Okay. Let's get them on the rail. Let's get them marching towards. Set all to march. And the Madras cancel. This is the garrison. Everyone else, I think I might have missed it last turn. We have a base group, RAF. This was the one that was. What the heck? Oh, okay, there it is. Get on the rail. Down to. Kompong Chenang. Nobody else. Another more coming from. Mulmian. Okay, marching down the trail. More have arrived. Set everybody into combat. Yep, they're still disembarking from the trains. Everybody's disembarking from the trains. So it's not anyone, no advantage to anybody. Why is this one still saying Singapore? Huh. Alright. Set it for Kobe. Like everybody else. Ah, but this one's mobile. Are there any here other than the engineers that are actually off the train? There's a few. Okay, I guess I'll have to get them marching. The Gurkha, the Chindits have already marched in. We conducted a deliberate attack. We're grinding down the enemy. 1-to-1 odds. It's okay. 1-to-1 is fine. Just grind them, grind them, grind them. I will move all these other ones. We're starting to march. I'm going to march them to Georgetown. Let's see, does that work? Yes, northwest. Set all to march. The engineers are the exception. We have headquarters units. This air headquarters is going to cancel. I know I should probably stay in strategic. That's probably the best for these air headquarters. Everyone else can march. Yeah, the air headquarters will stay. The engineers, we're going to drop them down to strategic. This will cancel the movement order. Then drop them back into combat. This will put them back into combat. Into function so that the radars and everything will work. Kotobaru, we were still building, trying to get it up to 8. Yep. Oh, I don't know what the hell that. Well, that's the demand is high because of all the army units in here right now. Singapore, submarine under repair. Ah, we've been flying recon over here. Yep, 9 out of 10. Let's check the recon pilots. Recon. I want to make sure that they're not too tired. Ah, recon fatigue is only 1. That's good. I am going to... we've been flying recon over Singapore. We're going to need to do the same thing over Langve. I forgot. If we don't fly recon, the bombing results aren't as good. So I'm going to start the recon... The Mitchells, they can upgrade to Spitfires. The Spitfires don't have very long range. Normal radius is 9, but I like these Mitchells because they have a good radius of 20, and they can conduct some very long range reconnaissance. So I'm going to upgrade. I'm going to save the Mitchells for a time when I actually need them for the longer range. Right now I'm going to change to Spitfires. Sure, we'll do that upgrade. And with the Spitfires we can conduct reconnaissance over shorter range targets. See, the 9, we can fly over Georgetown or Langkawi easily. Okay, next, I should have just used the damn drop tanks and brought them in here. Oh well, now I've got to add the pilots. Here's what I'm trying to do. I've moved the dive bombers down here, the Vengeance, and I'm bringing a bunch more of these Vengeance dive bombers simply because they, against little ships like subchasers and E-boat escorts, these guys are probably the best, I think. Whether or not we kill anything on the base is less relevant. I want to kill these things, subchasers here. And they're more accurate than the level bombers. I think I'm going to start I'm gonna put a search of 10% on these all these guys. I may or may not keep the B-25 Charlies over here. I have upgraded a whole bunch of the rear area. Anything that could become a Vengeance dive bomber, I've made into a Vengeance dive bomber. Upgraded them. With them flying over Singapore, this strait should be totally closed to the enemy. I'm going to try to fly the Navy bombers and or the B-25s, B-26. We'll fly them out of Kota Baru for a while, trying to destroy Langkawi. Just because it's once it's destroyed, I can pull out. I can take the place by parachute assault and pull out, and we'll go back to practice bombing from Chittagong or from Bangkok. But until that time, we're going to use the Venturas and the Mitchells and the Marauders to try and destroy this garrison. And then we'll just, then we'll use Bangkok or wherever, or come back up to Chittagong to finish them off. NORAD transport, we're going to dock, load the last, here's the last fragment. We've loaded 99% and we still can't get all of it. Oh, you buggers. All right. Let's set it for Chittagong. Yeah, you know what? I could just probably... set for Chittagong and return to Chittagong. Just because... Where's the last group? Here, these guys will pick up. Okay, we'll use NORAD. NORAD will drop off and come back. We'll pick up these guys here. We're picking up these base forces. Returning them to Chittagong. That'll work. No other reinforcements coming through the north. No activity on Ceylon. No enemy detected in Bombay or Arabian Sea. So these are just convoys, regular convoys in and out. No additional reinforcements from Aden. No additional reinforcements in Cape Town or South or Africa. Mombasa, we've arrived. We refueled and we're waiting. 18 days for the division to arrive at Mombasa. Submarine check. We have Gudgeon. Ooh, Gudgeon got herself hurt. Thank you for the button. Grunion, already coming back. Nobody else damaged. Nope. Check for fuel. We have Seal, I think, is already heading. Yes, already returning. Halibut, returning. Gudgeon, nobody else. Checking for torpedo. Several torpedo engagements, but they all submarines still have torpedoes and can maintain their patrols. So in Timor, yeah, we have Darwin again. Not much else. Hollandia, Papua New Guinea, quiet. Quiet in the Solomons. Okay, we're sending these off. I'm trying to replace the submarine tender up here, because the Langley can actually operate its own air group, so I can use it like a little mini seaplane sweeper. That normally these seaplane tenders, they only offer air aviation support, so they have to be docked at a base somewhere in order to provide aviation support, whereas the this one, the Arend, can carry one airplane, has aircraft capacity by itself, and the Langley can carry four. So she can walk, she can sail around, cruise around, and activate as a search platform. So that makes it a lot different from these other ones. So I'm trying to replace her and send the Langley and the Arend out to patrol the sea lanes. Maybe we can nail some of these submarines. Convoy coming back. Let's see, where's my damaged boat? Oh, come on. Did he get back? Yeah, he got back. Woohoo! Medusa. Nicely done. Let's go to critical. Let's pump this sucker as fast as we can. Woo! 10 days to get it done. Okay, 10 days to get rid of all the flotation and system damage, bring it down to 62, and then maybe we will try to get her back. Oh, we better refuel these guys. Who doesn't refuel when they get in? My goodness. We better refuel the one damaged too. Yeah. And then we'll have to work her back down to Brisbane for a proper repair. But at least this time we'll send more escorts with her. So that's what I'm trying to do with these escorts, these AVPs. I don't know why the aviation support tender. What's a P stand for? I don't know. We're trying to change them out for the. For the Langley. Okay, these guys. What the hell are you doing? This guy's withdrawing. Why would you be. Oh, you idiot. Just stay here. You're going to withdraw in 18 days, for goodness sake. You can withdraw from anywhere. Southwest Base Force. Quiet. Quiet in the Hebrides. Nothing in Suva. On Panama, we have the cable. I'm just going to send it right for Guam. Undock. Pearl Harbor, we have more. Yeah, these guys are just coming in. We're going to drop off the sub chasers and then head over. Hell, you know. Hell, we're here already. Let's just set for Guam. Go for Guam. Return for Guam. Unload at Guam. Form. Yeah. I mean, these guys are here. We're on the doorstep. Let's go to Pearl Harbor. Refuel and disband. Transport's heading back. Turn on the refuel. Let's look for the aircraft at Pearl Harbor. Any aircraft? The Dauntlesses. They're building up 20. Oh, well, that's a pretty big squadron. How did we get 24 aircraft into the squadron? Oh, are there spares? Oh, well, let's divide it. Let's just in case. Maybe there are some spare aircraft here. I don't want to lose them. We've already bought them, so yeah, it should be only 18 aircraft in here. Is it 18 plus 6 spares? Is that what it comes down to? Maybe that's how the game is calculating it. 18 plus 6 spares would be reasonable. Okay, they're resting. As they recover, I'm going to make sure we turn off the training so that the pilots do not get tired and they're ready to fly as soon as the planes are repaired. No aircraft on Palmyra, no aircraft on Johnson. We're not moving them forward. The air units are on Wootje. Okay, the Marauders, let's fly them out to their parent units. Where are you? There you go. Guam. Disband. Yep. Marauder. Transfer. There you go. Rota. Join your parent unit. These guys are staying here. Any of it here? Dauntless is here. And Malolalap. Okay. So we're settled. On Eniwetok, we have the 5th Marine Defense Battalion has arrived. Withdrawn 290. That's another year. 290 days. That's okay. I'll accept it. We'll pick up the two CB battalions. Uh-oh. No, we can't pick up the CBs yet because they're still building. Oh, they're building. It's really tough to build anything on. It's a zero. So it's really a struggle to build anything on any weed talk. I guess we can't take the CBs just yet. Bone ape. No aircraft to go. We're just maintaining. We should. Gosh. This is one of my forward positions. I'm going to load it up with aircraft. Well, yeah, let's keep this one loaded because this is the closest to truck, and I want to keep as many aircraft as possible in the squadron and flying. It's got to let me know when those damned invasions come through. Shipwise, repairs. We've got Saratoga in for critical, and a drop is a minesweeper. It's no big deal. We'll just leave it. It's not a big priority. On West Coast, transports have returned. Yep. Replenish, disband. Replenish, disband. Ooh, yeah, such fun. Replenish, disband. There's my AKV returning. These guys are almost loaded. These guys are loaded. Okay, off they go. Yeah, we're not worried about the rinky-dink last few drops of fuel. Out you go to Guam. Units in, check for refits and conduct repairs. All the ships have, we tried to reduce them down to 1 day readiness. Tenders are loaded. This tender, okay, this transport's ready to go. We're going to add it. Where's the tender? Otis? May as well. I've been thinking maybe I should save the tenders for those fast missions. The tenders generally have pretty decent speed, so I'm not going to saddle the slow convoys with them. I'm going to save the tenders for special missions, like resupply of the bases in the Hebrides, in the Marshalls. That might be best. They're fast. They can get in there quickly. No other units have arrived. We have target. Hold on. We have a base force here. This is a fully kind of no. Well, it needs upgrades, but otherwise it's ready to go. We'll upgrade it. Do I want to use up rifle squads? I don't need the most modern radar on this one. So I'm going to keep the rifle squads. This is a 1941 rifle squad, and that's fine. They're never going to be used. So what I'm going to do is I will take replacements, but I'm not going to take the upgrade on this one. They're ready to go. We're just going to get them into PACT and send them off for Kochi. Their most valuable asset or attribute is their 100 naval support. Anybody else? So here's another base force. This base force is still trying to recover. Nobody else ready to go. So we're just going to form no other reinforcements. The AKVs, we have three AKVs. Well, how many are here? Yeah, three AKVs. Two, some of them are being repaired. So I'm waiting for the other one to repair. Then we're going to load the AKV with the Thunderbolts and send them off to, I don't know, Guam or Pearl Harbor. I can't decide. Maybe it might just go to Guam. Operations report. Any other reinforcements on the West Coast? Yeah, lots. There's aviation. Oh, man. There's... Oh, boy. There's aviation base force. Okay. Let's go get them. Eastern, Los Angeles, Portland, Los Angeles. Oh, wow. I didn't notice. I missed it. Engineer, the base force. Okay, we'll go into... What is this? This one goes into combat mode. We will load the aviation base force, get these prepared. for embarkation. What else was there? Los Angeles had ships, form transport. No convenient button, so we'll have to do the manual garbage. Yeah, and I come up here, then I come down here, and then I have to go over here, and then I have to go. Yeah, I know. That was so much fun. Did we have any ground unit here? Nope, but we do have it on Port Wenim. Okay, we'll turn on the engineer. Set for move up to San Francisco. Set all and set all to march. Oh, we also have to set the landing planning for Kochi. Set all. Anybody else? I just can't remember who the hell just arrived. Try that again. Look again. Just how do you Okay, San Francisco we took care of. Oh, there's Seattle, Marchfield, and Portland. Right. Marchfield is here. Oh, another core. Good. We'll take upgrade. It's just support squads. There's nothing really to which we can upgrade. And we'll take the planning for Kochi and send for send it up to San Francisco. Portland! Form transport. Yep. Manual. God, I missed that button. What else was there? Portland. Still can't remember. Oh! Portland. March. Portland. Seattle! Base force, Seattle. Gotcha. Okay, Seattle has a base force. Good, this one's already purchased, ready to go. Same difference here. The advantage is the aviation support. Why? No, I'll take replacements to replace the rifle squad, but I'm not going to upgrade. No point in it. It's going to be a rear area unit. Don't waste good squads on REMFs, rear echelon mother finaglers. Eastern, we have aircraft here. Oh, Mitchell. Okay. Train them low. All Mitchells. What kind of air pilots have we got? This guy's a graduate, but everybody else here's a dud. So we're going to be training for ground bombing. This is a bomber that it's no longer restricted, so we can take this out, and I want to bring this over to the range. So what I'm going to do is there's a couple of these guys are 57s and 57 and 31s. Okay, I'm going to graduate them. Everybody, hold on. These guys aren't bad either. Okay, they're all 50s over here. So right now we have a whole bunch of guys. These are all brand new raw recruits. Let's see if there are any other raw recruits. Wow, look how slowly that goes. Shrunk, shrunk, shrunk. We've got plenty of crappy pilots down here, but these are all pretty decent. Oh, no, not these guys. We could use, these are 34s. See, these are naval bomber pilots. See, look at them. All of them are qualified naval bomber pilots. Let's just grab one, two, three, but it's still low experience, see? Okay, that's four. However, that's 12. That's 16. That's 16 pilots. Plus, we can get five more. This is the one-third extra. ground bomber. We'll start from here. One, two, three, four, and five. Well, of course. Oh, for God's sakes. Can you tell which green one I just selected? Because I can't. Freaking heck. You piece of garbage. Now I gotta go all... What's this little... This one right here. For the love of God, what a piece of crap this interface is. 21. All right. So we're going to set all the bombers here for the same thing. We're now training for... What we're doing is, even though these are well-qualified naval bombers, we don't have any... We don't have enough experience on them. So I'm going to train them on ground, and then we're going to move over to the Asia, or... Yeah, probably to Asia, and use them as bomb trainers, trying to get that experience up. So we've got them loaded with 21 pilots. Now we're going to move them to San Francisco. Now we have to go through the same ordeal with this one. Pilots. Yeah, I'm just going to leave these guys down here. The ground qualified ones I'm going to take out. All these 60s. Look at them. Look at all that experience. That's a lot of experience. Heck, I'm going to do it this way. Release 5. Release 1, 2, 3. Everyone else, except this last guy, has only 27. Now we're going to grab... Yep. Bomber pilots. Low ground skill. And also low, but this is experience of 56. I'm going to leave them. We'll take this guy. 130, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Yeah, this is boring as snot. I know, and I have to do it. I have to do every single squadron. And the two that got missed here. All right, now we have, that should be 21 pilots here. Yep, activate them all, or the ones we can. We'll be training along as we go across on the ship. So these guys will be training. I'm going to send these over to Asia once we get over there. Those two are taken. Any others? I don't think there are any other reinforcements. Okay, here's that A. He sailed right past the submarine zone. Okay, well. He got past, no problem. Wow, he should make a pretty uneventful run out there. Oh, the sloppiness, the things that happened. You just missed it. Just totally missed it. We're on the topic of seaplane tenders, and I think I'll deal with it now. There's a number of aircraft. For example, these little detachments, seaplane tenders. We'll talk about float planes right now. The little float planes here, not so much these shore-based ones. No, these are the Navy, United States Navy ones. But these little one detachments of single planes that were on cruisers, and I think when the cruisers upgraded, they lost use of them, but the planes have not disappeared. I've just been using them as training and searching around in the local waters around Pearl, but we all know nothing's going to really happen over here anymore. So I'd like to get them back into operation. And when I'm speaking about the tenders, and we were talking about, I was saying about, here's the tenders, we're moving the tenders up here to replace the seaplane tender at Cooktown. I'm going to form up a transport, let's form a transport. Let's just get them off the base. Now, this Langley can carry 4 aircraft. I've brought 4 Kingfishers over. Where are they now? Yeah, Kingfisher's over. This is from some one of the cruisers that got sunk. It's got four aircraft on here. We're going to transfer it over to a ship, Langley. Yeah, you may result in some loss. Sure, there's no loss. they're just fine. What I'm going to do is I'm going to fly them on anti-submarine patrol. Anti-submarine patrol, 80%. So they can make their own little mini patrol zone as they travel. So that's why I want to use these aviation tenders. Now this one's still being used to, this one's still needed because Cooktown has a bunch of float planes. Where are they? Patrol planes that need them. Which is why I'm bringing up the AVPs. These AVPs are also float plane, seaplane tenders. Now the problem, now that's fine. These seaplane tenders will, or whatever you call these little things, will be able to take care of the 25 or 20 so odd aircraft up here. They'll replace it, and then I can take the Langley and go off and cause trouble and load it up and use it as a mobile float plane base. I'm doing this because I've got convoys coming in anyway to pick up units over on Townsville. I may as well, the seaplane tender is going to try to hitch a ride out with them. I also got a better idea. Now, one of these, some better ideas, the some of these seaplane tenders, like the Errand, there's only two of them. These can also carry aircraft. So I'm thinking I can use those last fragments, those one plane detachments that for Walrus out of here. I can use those one plane detachments if I can get them onto the tenders. Now these guys don't have very much range. They're only like 1600 or so. But hey, or this one actually has 6000. So it's not bad. Now the beauty of these little, there's only two of them. There's one here and there's one here. Well, trapped in Darwin. Can't really get it out of there. But I want to get a seaplane onto which one is it? Is it Orion or Vulk? Vulk. It's the Vulk. If you can carry out, it's like carrying around your own personal seaplane, your own personal security guard, police officer here. So if I can get one out there, they're the only two in the game, and there are no more coming that can use them. So I can try to use up those last two. I don't want to tie up a seaplane tender. These little guys, they're not great, but at least, well, not this one. And not this one, but Erin at least can carry the plane. That's about all she can do. She can provide eyes for everybody else. The Heron has a depth charge rack, so I don't want to. If I can avoid it, I'll keep her out of there. I'll use her on regular patrol because she at least has depth charge capability. These other ones, I don't care. They're just a machine gun. They're no use for anything else, so I may as well just throw them up here and let them sit out the whole war on this one. But if I want to get the Heron out of here, this one I need to replace it with another tender. So what I'm going to do is I'll put these AVPs up here to take care of Cooktown, get this tender out, hopefully get her down here and sailing back to the States and operating. Langley also needs to upgrade. She hasn't upgraded for a year. So we've got Langley coming out. I've got two tenders over on Guam, and they just finished unloading. So what I'm going to do with these tenders, there are no more upgrades for these guys, and they handle 36 aircraft, so they handle a lot of aircraft. I'm going to take the tenders. I'm going to put them out. They're going to wait for the next retrieval convoy from Australia to come, Papua, I guess I called them the Townsville convoy, come back, and then they'll follow down, and then they'll replace the one at Cooktown. I'm bringing both of them because there's another one over here. Tulagi has another one, a Tangier. It doesn't carry seaplanes, but it's also due for an upgrade. It's overdue for an upgrade. And not that I'm anal about upgrades, but hey, I have to bring, Guadalcanal is short on supplies. I'm going to have to bring a replenishment convoy up to Guadalcanal anyway. I may as well pick up the tender, replace the tender with an upgraded tender, take this one back, bring it back for upgrades. So It's. I'm not anal about always getting the upgrade, but heck, they're on the way. We have to do it anyway. I may as well. So I'm going to try to get those two of those single plane detachments out from Pearl Harbor over to the little guys out here. Problem is, the little guys, look at these seaplanes, these little float planes. They got a range of 11. Freaking, it's me. Is it even worth the effort? I don't. Sure, getting some use out of them, some patrol use out of them is better than getting no patrol use out of them right now. All they're doing is training right now, and I don't find that very efficient. So I got to get these guys out to these out somehow out to these guys to get down to these guys to get down to the tender here to get down to the tender over here. Holy crap! And Darwin. The nearest base is 13, so I can't even get it out here and fly it in. There's nothing that can fly them in. Oh boy, just a lovely, lovely, lovely situation. Can't nothing can be done about this. So I'm trying to get it onto the Erend and onto the Valk. Is it the Valk? Yes, it's the Valk out here. So I need to get two of them over here. I need to get some of two of them. They're such short range that they can't even I do an island hop to Johnson or down to Palmyra and everything. Everything's at least 20 hexes. So the only thing I can do is carry the damn things all the way up to Guam and let them transship onto one of the tenders and move forward like that. Oh, what grief, what grief, eh? So do I send two or do I send three of them? They're not doing a hell of a lot back here. I'm going to form a transport. We've got these little. That's why we have these little AKLs. They're not even very useful. Like the one, two, three. Let's load those guys. Let's get them up there. The three float planes. This is, oops. This patrol. What happened to them? What happened? Oh yes, these little guys. Two. Three. We'll get some utility out of them, better than no utility out of them. So I gotta waste a couple of these little guys to bring them all the way up to Guam to transship. Let's hope they're worthwhile, hey? Just too funny, these little things, little things in life. Right. Okay. Now we're over on Guam. I've reorganized everybody. The seaplane tenders. I'm going to keep these. Notice these seaplane tenders have an average speed of usually 16 or 18 or higher. 16, 17, 18, or even 20. I think I'll be keeping them for high speed, keeping them together for high speed runs. So the aviation ships are the same thing. The AV aviation ships are also fairly high speed. So when I use them for supply runs, rather than slow them down in convoys of 12, I'm going to have them run out on their own at their own rate. Now they're here, we're going to repair them. Ooh, lots of stuff to repair. Oh, and we've got several empty ships heading back. But everyone's watch. Everyone's who cares about that? Let's look at the invasion. The invasion's going forward. Here is my lead. This is assault lead, and everyone's keyed upon him. We'll move two up to here, and then probably another two hexes up to here next turn. The problem, I don't want to set my carriers to go follow. I don't want to follow. If we order them to follow, the assault ships will probably slow down to let them catch up. And I don't want to do that. I want to get the assault onto the target as quickly as possible. So it's kind of tricky trying to coordinate. If it goes here and the next one's going to be whoo, maybe up here. We're going to move. That's two and two. Here's my lead ship. Let's see if we can't go two and two. I'm trying to rendezvous them or get ahead of them. Not easy, but I'm guessing. I'm guessing. If I miss, the enemy will. At least we do have a couple of carriers here, providing, so it's not like they're going to be attacked, but it'd be better. I feel better with the main, with the big carriers on top of them, providing close support. This submarine, I don't know where the hell he's going around or whatnot, gives me the creeps when I see that. But what can you do? What can you do? So that's what I'm going to do with the seaplanes and float planes. I've started reconnaissance. Saipan is going to try to get some recon. Is it Saipan? No. Tinian has the recon headsets. We're going to start reconnaissance on Hahajima, trying to increase that detection level so that when we hit it with bombardment and or the landings, it will be more effective. Also, I've taken an opportunity. Some of the bombers here have had a chance to recover. They've gotten down to fatigue of zero. So I've launched them forward. I've sent them up to places like Shanghai. I went one to Amoy, one to Changsha, even one to Pakoy. I'm just trying to get them all into the theater so that we can get them over to the bombing training centers. Getting them bombing as soon as possible. Trusty evades a submarine chaser. Night attack on Qinhai. 8 Lancers intercept. No losses. Air attack in Qinhai. 1 Betty damaged. Qinhai, attack bombed again. 2 hits on the runway though. Gurnard evades an escort. Gato fires 4 torpedoes at a destroyer. Wow, they're still sending out, look at these little transports, and look at the escorts around them. 2 E-boats and a destroyer? Holy crap! For one little island freighter. Holy cow! Air attack on the anti-tank regiment that we left behind. Air attack on Fusan. Fighters are up, 15 up. 6 enemy bombers shot down. Airstrike on Iwo Jima. Whoa, we've got Oscars and everyone else out. Oh, damn it. 3 Wildcats destroyed, but we also sink 1 transport and 1 patrol cutter. Afternoon air attack, Fusan. The bow fighters intercept, no losses. At least they didn't shoot down the bow fighter. Bombing practice, Majuro. Bombing practice, Akyab. Air attack, Tanjung Pinang. Well, we're still wearing down the enemy, the Vengeance and the Mitchells. Good. More practice bombing, Majuro. Another air attack, Tanjung Pinang. Hitting that regiment. Air attack. Oh, the Kates. We're attacked near Iwo Jima. 7 Kates destroyed. Yeah, we got to be careful about this CAP, Combat Air Patrol bait. Coming in here and fighting it like that. We just lost 3 aircraft. Oh, plus a couple of dive bombers damaged. Going after a target over a heavily defended base. I think I'll switch them back. We'll just turn them to search instead of land strike, or else I'm going to have to send better escorts. TTR, bombardment. Bombardment, Rashin. Bombardment, Yenki. Deliberate attack. Kota, near Kota Baru, 3-1 odds. Oh, he's retreating, son of a bugger, towards Taiping. Bastard. Of course, after he makes me take 2 weeks to march in here, shock attack. Rashin, 342-1 odds. Enemy destroyed. The fortress. Shock attack. Harbin, 12,000-1 odds. It was fortification level 4. Let's see. We destroyed one unit. Oh, utterly. Utterly. Let's see. Come on, come on, come on. I hope I. Yep, we got it with relatively low damage. One heavy industry damaged. That's it. Okay, that's very satisfactory. Yankee, deliberate attack. 1-4. Ow! That hurt! All right. I got a little bit too big for my britches. The 33rd Chinese Corps, it was 250, I think, assault value. I didn't think there's much behind here. There's what, maybe, really, maybe 10 or 20 assault value on that side of it, I thought, because these are very, very low. Unfortunately, it's level 5 fortifications. Oh my God, that hurt! Well, they're just disabled, not destroyed. So we can recover from that. We can re but we're going to need more men. Harbin, the surviving unit has been wiped out by attrition.